We have an update on a story that 48 Hours correspondent Erin Moriarty has been following a long time about a man named Ryan Ferguson. He spent nearly a decade in a Missouri prison for a murder that he's always insisted he did not commit. Well, tonight, Ferguson, now 29 years old, is a free man thanks in no small part to Erin's relentless investigation of this case. And Erin is with us tonight. Erin?
Well, Scott, his release actually came as a surprise. A special prosecutor in the case was just appointed last Friday, so no one expected that just 4 days later, it would all be over.
First thing I did was just hug my parents and kiss my girlfriend.
He's been out of prison for just 24 hours, but Ryan Ferguson is already savoring the taste of his newfound freedom. Before supporters in the press last night, he spoke about the time and effort it took to get to this day.
To get arrested and to get charged for a crime you didn't commit, it's incredibly easy. But to get out of prison, it takes an army.
Ferguson's release followed a nearly decade-long campaign led by his father, Bill, to clear his son's name.
I've driven 9,000 miles in 21 days.
A Facebook page designed to draw attention to the case has attracted supporters from all over the world.
It's been amazing seeing the support.
Guilty of murder in the second degree.
Ferguson was convicted in 2005 of the murder of Kent Heitholt, a Columbia, Missouri newspaper sports editor. There was plenty of physical evidence found at the scene, but none of it matched Ferguson. There were two witnesses against him, a high school friend who claimed he helped Ferguson commit the late night robbery and murder. The other, a janitor who said he saw Ferguson at the crime scene. Both men later recanted and said they lied at his trial. Still, despite the lack of evidence, Ferguson's attorney, Kathleen Zellner, says he was running out of appeals.
We were at the last stage, the very last stage, and if you cannot get the conviction vacated at that stage, you're at the end of the road.
Last week, a Missouri appellate court found that prosecutors had concealed evidence from Ferguson's defense, denying him a fair trial. His conviction was thrown out. And late yesterday, the Missouri Attorney General announced he would not retry him.
It's better than, I would think, winning the Super Bowl. You know, we saved a life.
The Attorney General actually stated that he would not retry Ferguson at this time, which leaves open the possibility that he could bring charges later. But the evidence that exists today points to individuals other than Ferguson.
Erin, you became interested in this 8 years ago. Why did this catch your attention?
We had actually seen the police video of the main accuser. And at that time, this young man, Charles Erickson, seemed to know few details, if any, of the crime. But then at the trial, he became the star witness. And that was a troubling discrepancy.
Erin, thanks very much.